morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Brown County High School. It is an honor to stand here today as a representative of the class of 2015 leading today's commencement ceremony. We'll begin by welcoming the Brown County Choir in the singing of the national anthem, followed by myself and Alex Kakavikos in the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance. At this time, would everybody please rise?
Of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. Now, please welcome the salutatorian of the class of 2015, Sarah Kurtziel.
As our class separates for the first time, we are provided with unforeseen opportunities and new responsibilities. This is because we have yet to be granted the raw beauty of unfamiliarity. Of course, we were all perplexed that first day of freshman year, but even then, we knew what to expect from high school, and it was right next door to the junior high. But now, we have absolutely no idea what these next few years will bring. Perhaps the most important and new responsibility that we now have, however, is not the inherent obligation to continue to strive in academics and get good grades, but the duty we owe to ourselves in choosing who we will become. Up until now, we have been bound together in our education, athletics, and development. And while the connections we have made have molded who we are today and thus should not be forgotten, our new freedom gives us the chance to declare our needed and self-indulging definition of what we want to contribute to the world. For some, the goal of life is achieving happiness. For others, it is leaving behind a positive influence or legacy that will live for ages to come. Determining one's ultimate goal starts with defining one's values and beliefs, such as these. Maybe some of you have done this in high school through C4, building trades, or other interest-based programs. And if so, I applaud you for that. I, on the other hand, only have a general concept accompanied by various blurry possibilities. This can be attributed to the fact that we are each unique individuals with our own passions and our own talents. I encourage you, in your first true chance at self-definition, to step away from the norm and differentiate yourself from others. I know we all love the shelter of a close group of friends, staying connected through social media, and having the safety net of a particular identity. But it is these very luxuries that stunt our evolution as individuals. Going back to my general concept of my future, I know that I want to help the defeated, both human and animal. I'm that person in class that cries when we learn about global warming and its effect on different species. I get angry when I see or hear the mistreatment of others. And I am paralyzed as my heart aches for those who are helpless as they lose their loved ones. This is why I aim to become a pediatric oncologist. Like I have said, however, we are all different. Maybe he wants to run a business, she wants to be a teacher, and you want to become a mechanic. But what if you are one of the many who do not yet know what they really, really want to do? I suggest looking to yourself and only yourself for such answers, because it is in times of great struggle and loneliness that we determine what is truly important to us. And this is because there is no one there telling you the right answer. In fact, there may not be a right answer. And it's okay to be unsure. I promise that all of us are in one way or another. However, if you do happen to know what you want to do, great. I challenge you to make a difference with it, because it is our individual quirks that will make our legacies and goals innovative and unforgettable. In a world that is often deemed to be deteriorating from greed and selfishness, working for the well-being of others will be the greatest contribution that you can make. The selfish part of this is doing so in a way that you can love and appreciate. To close, I would like to share with you an insightful quote from Alan Alda, a professional actor you may recognize from the show MASH. This quote briefly describes the worthwhile but difficult journey of separating yourself from others in order to establish your intellectual and moral independence. It reads, "You have to leave the city of your comfort and go into the wilderness of your own intuition. You can't get there by bus, only by hard work and risk, and by not quite knowing what you're doing. But what you'll discover will be wonderful. What you'll discover will be yourself." Thank you.
Now, please join me in welcoming the valedictorian of the class of 2015 and my dear friend, Rose Gingrich.
If there is one thing I learned in high school, is that even if you work as hard as you possibly can, you do not always get the recognition or rewards you want. But it is your reaction to these disappointments that makes you a success. You may not be the fastest on your cross-country team, the best artist, or the child that your parents talk about the most. But even if you do not get that MVP award, the ribbon for best in show, or the extra helping of dessert your mom saved for the favorite child at dinner, as long as you keep a positive and encouraging attitude toward yourself and the ones that receive the awards, you have not faltered. When you fail to preserve a quality relationship with yourself and others, that is a true disappointment. What I want to stress to you today is that it's not your accomplishments, your job, your income, or the place in which you live that are necessarily the most important. It is the people you meet in the course of the rest of your life, the relationships you create, and putting those people first that are the most fulfilling parts of your existence. Let me propose a scenario for you. Imagine a world in which Adam Smith is wrong. If you do not know who this is, Adam Smith is a man who developed the theory of the invisible hand that guides a capitalistic economy. He claims that people initially look out for their own interests, but then directly, but not purposely, benefit another person. A good example of this is when I buy cheesecake at Olive Garden. Not that this happens often, just saying. I, the consumer, get the personal satisfaction of the best tasting dessert in the world, and my money benefits the owner inadvertently by the increase in his income, which he then uses to buy a new Hawaiian shirt that he loves and his wife hates. Now imagine, if the motive behind this transaction were to be reversed. What if, instead of making a decision with themselves first in mind, people acted out of desire to satisfy others? Then, the benefit given to the giver, to the next person, may come back to the giver in the same way of the scenario I described, but with a better initial motive. It is objective behind a process that matters, not the end result. It is in this way that I urge you to live your life. Put others first. Nourish those relationships you have and that you'll soon make as you go off to college or wherever these next few months will take you. Nourish them by forgetting yourself, having patience, kindness, and a willing heart to listen. Because what you'll remember when you're 70 are not the shiny new car you bought at 33, because by then it's an antique in a junkyard, the promotion you received at work, or your favorite vacation spot. What you will remember is a friend you drove in the car for the first time with the radio up high, the coworkers you impacted with your leadership and time, and the loved ones you laughed with around the campfire on a late summer's night. It's not about how big your wedding is or how extravagant the decorations look. It's about whose eyes meet yours at the end of that aisle. It's not about your perfect first house you buy. It's about your baby's first steps on that white carpet you tried so hard to keep clean, and about the realization that it doesn't even matter because what you have is a miracle in your arms. It is not your house that will be comforting you in the end, but your spouse or your best friend, or both if that's the case. John 15:13 states, "Greater love has no one but this, that someone lay down her life for her friends." Those people whose lives you put first and cherish will be who make your own life worthwhile, complete, and memorable. Class of 2015, I want to congratulate you on completing this chapter of your life. Now, let's make the next one worth remembering. Thank you.
Nathan Williamson is an English learner specialist at the Indiana Department of Education. Nathan earned his Bachelor's of Science in Elementary Education and his Master's of Science in Language Education from Indiana University. He was an educator for Center Grove Community Schools and Indianapolis Public Schools, where he worked as an elementary and middle school teacher. He serves on several educational committees in Indiana and is an adjunct professor for Indiana University. Nathan is a graduate of Brown County High School and former student of Nashville Elementary and Brown County Junior High. He lives with his wife, Megan, and four children in Bartlesville, Indiana. Ladies and gentlemen, Nathan Williamson.
Families, friends, community of Brown County, Principal Killinger, Superintendent Schaefer, teachers, staff, parents, and most importantly, the class of 2015. Thank you for having me here today. Class of 2015, you made it. Congratulations. Today is the beginning of a new chapter. I am honored to be here today, and this really is a defining milestone for me. My name is Nathan Williamson. I am a 2004 graduate of Brown County High School. Even though that was a short time ago, I honestly don't remember a whole lot about my graduation day. I was excited for what was ahead, and I hope you all are too. And I hope today that I can share some experiences with you that will be a source of information for inspiration for what lies ahead. You are here today because you made a choice. Graduating from high school is not an easy task. At least it wasn't for me. Many of you have jobs, family responsibilities, and quite frankly, things that might seem more interesting than going to class the last week of your senior year. but you made the choice to finish. The diplomas you will receive today were earned, so feel proud of yourselves. However, none of you did this alone. I see a very full gym today. People who are here who care about you, and there are others who can't be here that wish they could. Every single one of you has someone in your life who made a difference, who pushed you, who helped you get to this point today. So one of your tasks that I give you after today is over is to find those people who made that difference, who pushed you, who made you to the person you are today. Find them, thank them, and commit to being that person that makes a difference for someone else in the future. When I think of how I got to where I am today, I think of my parents first. They're actually here today. I told them not to come. They didn't have to come, but they came anyways. For many of you, that might be a grandparent. That might be an aunt. It might be a family friend that you think of first. Cherish those people, because now and later in life, you will need to lean on those people. The relationships you make and develop with your friends and family will prove invaluable in the future. I next think of my teachers, many of them who I had that are sitting here today. I had the privilege of attending Nashville Elementary, Brown County Junior High, and Brown County High School. The great experience I had growing up in Brown County and attending school here helped push me to what I became, a teacher. I had many teachers who invested in me, and it truly was an investment, because teaching is not just about reading books or learning algebra or completing an experiment, but learning how to become a good person and how to work with others. Whenever I share a story about my own children and how ornery they can be, my sixth grade teacher, Ms. Kilgore, reminds me they got it from me. I remember deciding my class schedule for junior high, and I did not want to take honors English because I did not like that subject very much. Ms. Kilgore said, "No, you're going to." At least that's how I remember it. She said, "You're too good of a writer to not push yourself." I later ended up becoming an English teacher, so thank you, Ms. Kilgore. In junior high, I had not decided to work very hard yet. And one day in my eighth grade social studies class, Mr. Robinson caught me cheating on a test, which I actually never told my mom about, so I'm sorry, Mom. He pulled me in the hallway and said, "No, you're better than that." Thank you, Mr. Robinson. In high school, I enjoyed music so much, but I also wanted to take calculus. Any high school counselor or principal knows how difficult making a master schedule can be, and I had to make a choice. I went to my calculus teacher, Mr. Langell, and asked if I could just show up to class sometimes when I needed to, and I would study mostly on my own so that I could play in the jazz band. He said yes, because I think he recognized how important music was to me and wanted that interest to grow. At least that's how I saw it. So thank you, Mr. Langell. Many of you have had teachers who have done the same for you, so find those people and thank them. My dad is a 1971 graduate of Brown County High School, and my grandfather is a 1945 graduate of Nashville High School. My great-grandmother moved to Brown County nearly 100 years ago, and I still have family that lives here today. When I was in school, I often thought that I couldn't wait for the day when I could live somewhere else that I thought would be more exciting and would have more things to do. As time has passed, and the more I think about Brown County, the more I can't wait to come back. After teaching for several years, I had the opportunity 2 years ago to start working for the Indiana Department of Education and Superintendent Ritz. I work with all school districts in Indiana, helping them meet the unique needs of their students, and I get to visit lots of schools. The department has a system where they tell the community what kind of quality of a school that the children attend. And when I think of Brown County in that system, I think of an A. When I looked, sure enough, Brown County schools are A's. However, these A's are measured by things like reading and math tests and graduation rates. But the A isn't measured by the relationships that you have with your teachers or the clothing given to you when you were in need, or the lessons that you learned that didn't come from a textbook. Brown County is an A in those areas too. In all the schools that I've worked with and visited, I'm not sure I've been in one yet that is better than the experience I remember here. So students, be proud of where you are from. Class of 2015, your class motto is remember yesterday, dream for tomorrow, and live for today. It's actually quite good. It makes me draw a comparison to my wife's class motto. She's a 2005 graduate of Brown County, and her well-written class motto was, get her done. So, whatever committee helped you write your class motto this year, please thank them. Your parents thank you, and the rest of us do too. I want to share some things with you that I've learned to help you realize your class motto, to live it out. Find what you are passionate about and figure out a way to do it each day. My passion is making a difference for kids, and what I do every day honors that passion. There are other paths that might have made more sense, but your passion always needs to trump common sense. Don't let someone else's opinion of you become your reality. Next, rejection is inevitable, but often it has very little to do with you. It may have not been the right timing, or it just wasn't meant to be. Keep a relentless determination to succeed. You will stumble, but how you respond is what matters. Most people are not extraordinary, including myself. However, you can do extraordinary things. Do the little things right every day, and the big things will take care of themselves. Surround yourselves with people who don't agree with you, people who will tell you no matter what or how much you don't want to hear it, they'll tell you the truth. Those people will help you be better tomorrow than you are today. When you find people that you don't really care to be around, but you still have to be around those people, kill them with kindness. Burning bridges usually does not work. Balance your life. Don't push yourself till you burn out. Take risks. Don't let your young age make you question whether you can do something great. But also don't think you're going to be great at everything. There are going to be some things that you're horrible at. But learn from others, especially those that have done it before you. And try to have fun while you're at it. I want to leave you with this. Set goals for yourself and what you want to do. I was reading a study about graduates from the Harvard School of Business. The study asked, have you set clear written goals for yourself in the future? The study found that 84% of students had no goals whatsoever. 13% of the students did have some goals, but they never wrote them down. Those 13% of students earned twice the salary as the 84% who had no goals. In comparison, the 3% of the graduating class not only had goals, but they wrote them down in order to hold themselves accountable to themselves and others. This 3% earned, on average, as much, 10 times as much, as the other 97% of their class combined. Now, money is not the best way to quantify success and is not the best way to gauge happiness. The teachers at Brown County and then myself as a teacher know we did not get into teaching to make a whole lot of money. But it does remind us that if we can create a vision for ourselves, make it measurable to see how we are doing, and set benchmarks so that we can check in with others, then we will have more successes to celebrate. Today, tomorrow, and in the weeks, months, and years ahead, set your goals, figure out a way to make them happen. I'm Nathan Williamson, class of 2004. Thank you for listening.
Now the Brown County High School Choir will perform Joy Be With You All. Please welcome Principal Shane Killinger with the presentation of the class.
Good morning. Today I'd like to talk about two individuals and a class. The first individual I want to talk about is Ethan Wilson. For those of you that don't know, Ethan Wilson was part of this graduating class, and I got the pleasure to shake his hand last year because he graduated after his junior year. We lost Ethan to an automobile accident this year. And I hope that everyone please remembers the young man who had a positive impact, a wonderful smile, and I've never heard anyone who said anything but loved him and wished he was here. The other individual I want to talk about is John Mills. John Mills was a school board member for us. He was starting his third term. We lost him about a month ago. He also served on the board a couple of different terms earlier in his career. And John was a lifetime, he spent a lifetime of advocating for Brown County's youth. And we appreciate that and we thank him for that. So at this time, could we please have a moment of silence? Thank you. Let's talk about a class. When I started thinking about what I wanted to say today, it didn't take very long. I don't even know if I got out of the parking lot in my car. And the word came to me, diversity. What I'm going to remember about this class and what I'm going to miss about this class is the diversity. And what I mean by that is we have students that are achieving outstanding things academically, athletically, in the arts, and things that aren't in the normal school day, but are still important. My only advice to you, don't change. That diversity is what makes you special, and that diversity is what's going to make you successful after today. In closing, thank you for the positive impact you've had on this school, this community, and me. It's an honor to be here with you today. Thank you. Now it's my pleasure to present the class of 2015 to the School Board Trustees, Superintendent Dave Schaefer, and more importantly, the Brown County community. Mrs. Evans, would you please come up and read the names of our graduating class?
Rose Emily Ginrich. Sarah Jessica Kurdziel. Elizabeth McAvoy Jackson. Matthew Wayne Adams. Matthew Irvin Allen. Dakota Renee Anderson. Christopher Logan Axum. Katie Leanne Back. Mallory Dawn Baker. Carly Elizabeth Barnes. Corey Charles Barnes. Caleb Michael Bartley. Joe Bell. Chloe Danielle Biddle. Randy Brooke Blackledge. Cheyenne Lynn Blevins. Emily Rose Brady. Abigail Sue Brock. Kamara Brock. Ty Morgan Broussard. Garrett Leon Brown. Grace Faye Brown. Shay Robert Dwight Brown. Mason Cole Bryant. Cody Douglas Berker. Sierra Marlene Butler. Kimberly Leja Cagle. Tyler Wayne Cecil. Tanner Marie Chapman. Ian Samuel Chavez. Matthew David Childers. Carla Christine Caldwell. Trenton Curtis Cornelius. Caleb Anthony Couch. Jordan James Thomas Dawson. Joshua G. Deckard. Matthew Benjamin Dixon. Cameron Martin Markowitz. Austin Lee Dodson. Jay Derringer. Robbie Allen Dolph II. Corey Matthew Downs. Cheyenne Leslie Faye Ellis. Maya Nev Ellis. Amber Dawn Estes. Mariah Rose Fortner. Jacob Ryan Ford. Elijah Taylor Fox. Amanda Leanne Frenzenmeyer. Anthony James Gilbert. Estella K. Gonzalez. Amanda Jean Grabenhofer. Colin David Graber. Bryce Andrew Gray. Christopher James Harden. Luke Andrew Harden. Wyatt Allen Harmon. Brianna Lynn Harper. Cody Ray Hayes. DJ Hendershot. Catherine Taylor Higgins. Austin Jacob Holderman. Paul Ryan Houchin. Austin Lee Hudson. Courtney Renee Johnson. Kara Danielle Johnson. Alexandria Sky Kakavikos. Stephen Nathaniel Kakavikos Jr. Addison Lee Kelp. Cameron Eugene Kelp. Ethan Jacob King. Grant Noel Kinnick. Hannah Raquel Knauer. Casey Joe Lambert. Robert Lambert. Donald Jonathan Landry. Savannah Roseanne Lebo. Elizabeth Grace Lillette Leach. Joseph Leonard Lucas. Matthew Lynch. Troy Roger Mace. Kayliana Rochelle Marcou. Evan Daniel Markley. Christopher Ryan Martin. Mary Kate McCann. Emily Louise Metzger. Brooke Lynn Melton. Mitchell Matthew Miller. Logan Hunter Manette Bond. Gracie Ann O'Neill. Logan Danielle Oliphant. Jesse Lee Parr. Dakota Red Crowley Patterson. Jens Eric Pedersen. Lauren Elizabeth Phillips. Mary Kay Poole. Austin Kyle Pretty. Samantha Corrine Quimby. Brianna Lee Ratzberg. Evan Robert Richardson. Kylan Joseph Robertson. Harley Danielle Rogers. Evan Wayne Rose. Jordan Sue Rosebrock. Lacey Kimber Irene Ross. Edward Patrick Ryan. Taylor Louise Sanders. Mackenzie Joe Sandlin. Sarah Olivia Sheckel. Amber Nicole Sizemore. Adrian Elise Skirvin. Boone William Smith. Reagan Elena Smith. Robert Edward Smith. Casey Lynn Souders. April Nicole Spires. Jacob Ray Strickland. Natalie Marie Strunk. Madison Nash Stewart. Kirsten Dawn Taylor. Matthew Ryan Tietrick. Megan Nicole Tucker. Alex Michael Walker. Kylene Ann Warren. Jeffrey Scott Warham. Skylar Ann Watkins. Carly Beth Williams. Nina Mame Williams. Derek Daniel Wood. Matthew Scott Wright. Vincent Andrew Augustus Manson. Kaylin Ashley Wagers.
Sorry, I was supposed to introduce Mr. Schaefer, but I'm feeling lopsided. So, at this time, I would like to bring Superintendent David Schaefer to the podium.
I want to echo some of the words that have been said about our Brown County class of 2015. You have demonstrated a wide range of talents, and you have great opportunities ahead of you. We will be watching and enjoying those future successes that you will have, just as we have watched and cheered for you in the past. I also want to thank each parent of our class of 2015 students. Thank you for giving us the privilege to work with such a great group of young people. I will leave our class with this thought from the late entrepreneur and filmmaker Walt Disney. All our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. Let me offer each of you, members of the class of 2015, my congratulations. Now it's time for the class to graduate. Class members, would you please stand for the changing of your tassels?